Well, welcome to today's daily service. I'm thrilled that you've joined. So why don't we open today's service with some words of his from that what's called high priestly prayer. Let's say aloud together John 17, verse 3. Now this is eternal life, that they know you, the only true God, and Jesus Christ, whom you have sent. Let's pray. Father God, thank you that in Jesus, you didn't just give us a set of priorities that we could choose to adopt for our lives or not, but instead revealed to us the essence of life itself, to know you, the one true God, and Jesus Christ, your Son. Please would you use this service to help us to grow in our relationship with you through him. Please help us, God. Amen. Well, everyone answers the question as to what's most meaningful to them in life from the perspective of an overall view of the world. And for centuries, Christians have used the Apostles' Creed to answer that question. What's most important? What's the real, true, ultimate story of all things? So, if you are a Christian, would you join me in saying the Apostles' Creed together? I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Well, in our daily services this week, we're looking at John chapter 15, verses 1 through 8. Let's say the passage together. I'll read the odd-numbered verses, and could you join me in saying aloud the even-numbered ones? I am the true vine, and my Father is the gardener. All, he cuts off every branch in me that bears no fruit, while every branch that does bear fruit he prunes, so that it will be even more fruitful. You are already clean because of the word I have spoken to you. Together, remain in me, as I also remain in you. No branch can bear fruit by itself. It must remain in the vine. Neither can you bear fruit unless you remain in me. I am the vine. You are the branches. If you remain in me and I in you, you will bear much fruit. Apart from me, you can do nothing. If you do not remain in me, you are like a branch that is thrown away and withers. Such branches are picked up, thrown into the fire, and burned. But if you remain in me, and my words remain in you, ask whatever you wish, and it will be done for you. This is to my Father's glory, that you bear much fruit, showing yourselves to be my disciples. Well, as I think of a life that made a meaningful impact, I often think of the life of C.T. Studd. He was a student in Cambridge where he came to Christ. He came from a very wealthy family. He was a very able cricketer. And whatever you might think of the sport of cricket, you'll certainly appreciate what he did next. After coming to Jesus, he gave away a lot of his fortune and he pursued missionary activity in China. And when he later received an inheritance, he graciously gave it away, seeking the interests of Christ first. But if you don't know him, you might know his famous poem called Only One Life, or at least might have heard the refrain from that poem, which is repeated at the end of every stanza. Only one life, 'twill soon be past. Only what's done for Christ will last. Jesus here in our passage today certainly isn't saying anything less than that. Only what's done for Christ will last. He does seem to be saying that. But I think he's saying something even more. Would you hear again with me the words from verse 5? I am the vine, you are the branches. If you remain in me and I in you, you will bear much fruit. Apart from me, you can do nothing. Jesus uses the image of the vine, as we heard on Monday and yesterday. Jesus himself is the vine. He's the vine. And we who believe in him and follow him are the branches. If you believe in me and my words reside in you, I reside in you. And as you remain vitally connected to me, I'll live my life through you and you'll bear much fruit. And then he puts it negatively, but apart from me, you won't do anything. It's not anything less than C.T. Studd said, but I believe something more. Only one life, 'twill soon be past. Only what's done through Christ will last. So how is your connection to Jesus today? That will determine whether we're living lives of meaningful impact or not. Why don't we turn now to a time of confession? Let's pray together using these words that will come up on the screen. Lord, we have sinned. We have turned away from you and disobeyed you. We lift up our voice to you and cry for your mercy. There is no one else to whom we can go. Please save us from our sins and from the temptations that seem too strong for us. Please forgive us, as you have promised through Jesus' death on the cross, and help us to praise you as we should. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Jesus, thank you that you said through your Apostle John that if we confess our sins, you're faithful and just to forgive us our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. And as we've confessed our sins to you now, please assure us of your forgiveness and help us to live a life that's connected to you. Bear much fruit through us. In Jesus' name, amen. We continue with a prayer of general thanksgiving. Let's pray together. Almighty God and merciful Father, we give you humble and heartfelt thanks for all your goodness and loving kindness to us and to all people. We bless you for our creation and preservation and all the blessings of this life, but above all, for your immeasurable love in the redemption of the world by our Lord Jesus Christ, for the means of grace and for the hope of glory. And, we pray, give us such a sense of your mercies that our hearts may be truly thankful and that we may praise you not only with our lips but in our lives, serving you in holiness and righteousness all our days, through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit be honor and glory now and forever. Amen. We pray a prayer for all people. Let's pray. God of love, make your way known to the people of our world, your saving power among the nations. Guide and govern your church by your Holy Spirit, so that all who call themselves Christians may be led in the way of truth and hold the faith in unity of spirit, in the bond of peace, and in righteousness of life. We commend to your fatherly goodness all who are afflicted or distressed in body, mind, or circumstances. Relieve them according to their needs, giving them patience in their sufferings and deliverance from their afflictions. This we ask of Jesus Christ, our Savior. Amen. And Father, we take a moment in the quiet to bring to heart and mind those for whom we are most concerned right now. Please, would you take care of them? In Jesus' name, amen. And we close our prayers with this prayer, which I will just pray. You listen on. Lord, you have given us grace to agree in these our prayers, and you have promised that when two or three ask together in your name, you will grant their requests. Fulfill now, Lord, our desires and prayers as may be best for us. Grant us in this life knowledge of your truth, and in the age to come, life eternal. Amen. Well, let's sing together now. Well, thanks again for joining us today. I'll send you with these words from that same high priestly prayer that we began with. Jesus says, "As you sent me into the world, I send them into the world." So may you go now, knowing that Jesus is with you and is seeking to bear his fruit through you as you remain connected to him. Amen.